Hello, I'm College of the Desert President Emeritus, Dr. Joel Kinnamon. I'm running for the Desert Community College District's Board of Trustees for Area 4. You know it as the elected board that governs College of the Desert. It's unfortunate but true. COD's Board of Trustees is in a crisis. Newspaper headlines for the past year or more have pointed to a majority of the governing board violating the public's trust through deception, lack of transparency, and breaking its word on committed projects that would create greater access to education and equity for our students. It is a significant problem that affects all of us living in Coachella Valley. This November 8th, you have an opportunity to help fix it as you get to vote for one of the 5 seats on this important governing board. This board has oversight of nearly $1 billion in educational construction bond money. With 30 years of professional experience in community college and a doctorate in higher education, I hope you agree that I am the most qualified candidate. Over the past decade, I had the pleasure of getting to know you while serving as president of College of the Desert from July 2012 until March 31st, 2021. During my tenure, COD became the fastest growing community college in the entire state with a record number of COD college graduates. We eliminated financial barriers for our students by offering free tuition to every high school graduate in the Coachella Valley. We also offered free bus passes to get to and from classes at COD. This was made to each college student in exchange for those students providing community service in return. Additionally, it was under my leadership in 2016 that COD passed a $578 million bond measure. This bond measure is to build a promised West Valley campus in Palm Springs, to double the size of the East Valley campus in Indio, establish Roadrunner Motors in Cathedral City next to the Auto Center, and make significant improvements to the main campus in Palm Desert, such as the restoration of the Hill Library, the learning core of the college. When I retired in March 2021, more than a year ago, College of the Desert was in a significantly much better place than when I arrived. Over the 9 years, we transformed COD into a college honored with state and national awards for academic excellence, including the prestigious Bellwether and Aspen Awards. We won the State Chancellor Student Success Award for the entire state of California, twice. Much like business leaders, educational leaders do not succeed by thinking small or repeating what has already been done. Shortly after the voters passed Measure CC, the college community rolled up its sleeves. It went to work putting together the most innovative plan for College of the Desert. We heard volumes from our trustees, faculty, students, staff, business leaders, community stakeholders, and the general public. We hired the best educational industry experts and consulted with our local business leaders. The college leadership, including the COD trustees, traveled across the U.S. and internationally to look at best practices, conducted feasibility studies, and formed working task forces to meet the community's expectations as we put in place what we promised the voters. So why am I here speaking to you today? When I retired at the end of March 2021, our architects were finalizing Measure CC projects that adhered to all legal requirements and with construction to begin throughout Coachella Valley shortly thereafter. Since my retirement, a majority of the Board of Trustees, including incumbent Aurora Wilson, have allowed for the cancellation or the pause of vital college expansion plans. For example, the majority of the Board of Trustees allowed Roadrunner Motors in Cathedral City to be canceled in October 2021 without any notice or your input. After 6 months of public outcry, including those by city leaders, the board once again decided to reaffirm its original commitment to the voters and build Roadrunner Motors in Cathedral City. These decisions to delay projects are costing you, the taxpayers, more money. Their untimely delay during this period of inflation has caused the price of construction to increase by approximately $3 million. That's simply unforgivable. Newspaper headlines have described the majority of the board's oversight of Measure CC this past year as reckless. One local online newspaper described it with such furor that it cannot be read over public airways without a sound bleep. In the meantime, student access is delayed and negatively impacting future generations and family households. I find this unconscionable. And the only guarantee voters have to ensure these projects do not stop after the election, once again, is to vote for a new representative. So, we are at the pivotal fork in the road. The ability to get COD back on track lies with the leadership of the Board of Trustees working together to serve in the best interests of our community and fulfill its promises made to you. We have the ability to right the current wrongs by electing a new board member to the College of the Desert Board of Trustees. The election is on November 8th. We can stop the board's deceit, delays, and disinformation. In Area 4, board member and incumbent Aurora Wilson is up for re-election. She is part of the bare, simple majority of the board that has allowed COD to spiral down, and she needs to be voted out of office. As the former College of the Desert president and 30 years of community college experience, I'm committed to fulfilling the promises made to the voters and quickly getting the college back on track. I'm not a politician. I'm an educator with a proven track record in this community. I stand before you to ask for your vote to the Desert Community College District Board of Trustees, Area 4, this November 8th. And if I shall earn your vote, I promise you that COD will keep its prior commitments to the students and this community. COD will get back to being the fastest growing college in California. COD will once again win National Academic Excellence Awards through innovation, and COD will support our leading industries and businesses with highly trained workers. Finally, besides my extensive experience at College of the Desert, I'm the only person in this race that has announced a 7-point plan to get COD back on track. That includes the creation of a university center at COD. It would allow our students to earn a bachelor's or graduate level degree from leading universities like UCLA, UC Riverside, Cal Poly Pomona, CSU San Bernardino, and many more without having to leave College of the Desert or Coachella Valley. We can do it working together and save taxpayers money at the same time. I ask for your support, and I am confident that we will get COD back on track by working together for the benefit of our students and community. True leaders protect the sanctity of public educational systems. Please contact me, read my platform, donate, and/or sign up at Joel for COD. That's Joel, the number 4, COD.com. Those who sign up will also be invited to my campaign kickoff reception. That will be announced very soon. Thank you, and once a Roadrunner, always a Roadrunner, go Roadrunners. I'm Joel Kinnaman, and I approve this message.